Hello everyone, welcome to Athril Studio. Wish you all a very, very happy new year. If you all can hear me, please type in a yes so that we can start the session today. Welcome Preeti, Geeta, Pooja, welcome everyone. So just checking on the audio and the video, if it is all good, we can start with our day three. So I hope you all have watched a day two. Hello, happy, okay, thank you Mehak. Yes, so rest assured that you all can hear me well. Thank you so much for your wishes, and I wish you the same, wish you a very, very happy new year. You all have been such a great support, and all your love and dedication towards art, I really cherish that. And that's the way we are learning and sharing things. Welcome again. And today we will be doing our day three of our Pichhwai workshop. So in the day one, we did the talk about the history of it. What is Pichhwai? Why is it made? What are the main themes of this? What are the main subjects? And in the day two, we did a little elaborate study on how to draw and color a lotus, because lotus is a very big element in, it's a very common element in Pichhwai art, and we see that there are a lot of lotuses in different shapes and forms. I couldn't do the full-fledged video in the live for the last class, so sorry about that. I had something really urgent that came up. But I will be posting a video today as well, which will be a little more elaborate on how to do the Kamal Talai. So when we do the Kamal Talai, that Talai is a tala or the pond. When we do the pond, it's not only one lotus or one formation of lotus that we will see. We will see different shapes and different sizes, and therefore a little movement will be there. How to overlap the colors, how to give them the shape. I will show you, actually the picture that I did is right in front of me, but we will be going on to another subject, and the subject today is the peacock, the bird. And when we look at the Pichhwai pictures, we see that peacocks are very, very common. We sometimes see Shrinathji with 12 peacocks, and that is one of the themes of the painting. Either the theme of the Pichhwai painting is the festivals or the seasons. So when we are doing a picture that is talking more about the season, then the monsoon, then this element will be seen majorly. So one peacock followed by peahens and all will be seen. Good afternoon everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you for all your wishes. I wish 2022 is going to be really good for us. So I will be placing my camera on the table, and I will be showing you the Kamal Talai, what has been done. Please refer to the day two video if you have not seen. And followed by that, I will be sharing a full length video on this as well. So let's get started. I'll place it on the table. So today, what all stuff we will be needing? Many people have asked me whether we can use acrylic paints, watercolors, or what medium. So now it is up to you what paints you want to use. If you are using it on the canvas, you can also go for oil paints or acrylic paints. If you are using on MDF or wood, acrylic paints are the best. Now I am using it on the paper, and I will be using poster colors. Now what colors I'm using is only 6 colors, and I will be mixing and making all the shades. So what colors I get in this is, see, so here, so these are few shades that I will be using to do the full picture. There is no other shade, so we mix and match to get the colors, and we'll all be making the same colors. So these basic, very basic set of 6 will be with me today, and few brushes. So see to it that your brush is fine and smooth, should not be frayed, so that you get smooth lines. So few various tips. See, I have also received many questions like what brand of brushes I'm using. So see, there is no particular brand, though many of them, it is a recently bought set. So I have many from Camel, which is a 246. These brown ones are Camel. This is a local brand, but it has a very smooth lining and a very long bristle. So this goes well for lining purpose. So it doesn't depend on how, what brand you're using. It totally depends on how fine the tip is. So if in case you've used it so many times and it is fraying, then that means that even if it's whatever brand, you should not be picking that. Take a smoother one, which has a fine tip. If you have any questions, please type in the chat box and I will revert it to you. Now, a pencil, normal pencil, any pencil will do. A razor, I use this so that fine lines can be erased here. Any eraser and a pencil for a rough sketch. Now, I will be showing you something. It's a reveal that what I'm going to show you. So, this was a picture that I showed you in the day two. This is only this section was dealt very, very much in detail. But the flowers and the petals, everything, there are different elements in the pond. I will just pull my camera a little low so that you can have a look. So here, there are different shapes of leaves. Some are open towards the top, bent down, floating, raised up high. And not every place I have followed the same rule of outlining with the black. So here it's the outline with the black and here it's just a darker shape. So you can give that variation to give it a natural look. So this is one thing. Now, the video that I will be posting will be sharing you with every small element of it and with a much clarity on the camera. Right? There are two birds also. So when we do the Kamal Talai, it's not only that we do only lotuses and flat base that we have seen, we see many a times that when we do any picture or a home decor item, we just color a plate with just lotuses everywhere and the background is flat. So that is a very contemporary style of doing it. That is a mix and match of how do we do. But in traditional Pichhwai, we see that these grades, these lines in the waters, all these details are taken care of. And one Pichhwai takes a lot of time, so months to be made. So it is that way. Pichhwai needs more layer work and outline. Yes, of course it does. So that is why we cannot just rush with this. Today, I have actually, if you see this, I left with few of them. We will be doing one flower today, which is not this shade. There are water lilies also. And sometimes we see standing against a very dark background. So if the background is dark, how do we do the water lily? It is white and light bluish in shade. We will do that as well. So this is what, but you will receive a video also. Those who want to really go in depth and see how and how the mixing and what consistency, please check on that. Now this is an A3 size picture where at the bottom I have made around, if I measure it for you, this talai is about 5 inches. Okay, this portion here is about 5 inches and whatever is left up is about 9 inches. So 9 inches on the top. I'm taking a center place here. I'll just lift it up. Yeah. Okay, I'll take a center place here to do the a peacock. Now, peacock is very commonly seen, as I told you. You can take a normal pencil and draw. There are different types, different ways in which you can make the peacock. It's not always that they are going in certain direction and they have the same movement like a statue. It's not that. Everything is in a movement. So here, first, we have to decide how big peacock I want to make. So I will be taking one because half of it is already taken with Kamal Talai and I want just few clouds, trees and a peacock here in the center. So I will be just placing my area. So here I'm making, I've already made a lotus. Here is also one lily, water lily. And this is the place where I can just accommodate one of these. So here, just roughly giving it a small hill kind of a little higher pedestal here so that we can create a little bit of the ground, the land as well. So here, give me just a moment and I'll start with this. Here, and sorry about that. Here, we will be taking this, and now I'm placing my. So roughly how big, it totally depends on how big you want to do. Yes, what I'm taking Vaishnavi is an A3 size. You can take smaller elements and do it on anything, any coaster or anything. Here, suppose, I'll just show you. There are n number of things you can do with one element. So here, suppose this is a coaster that I did. Okay, I was just playing around with it actually. So I'll just share it in one of the videos. So it was just this colorless plastic coaster, which I never liked. And I converted it to this. So this is basically the very same method what I used here. But you will see that the poster colors are giving more chalky and more subtle look, whereas the acrylic is giving a little sheen. The shine is more. And moreover, it depends on the overhead light that I've put. So this. So you can see that the glaze comes off the light, whereas poster is very absorbent color, so it doesn't reflect any light. But of course, you can just do a varnish to protect it and you can use it. So the same things, whatever you learn on poster color, you can always try it on acrylics or on your oil, watercolors, anything. Okay, we will definitely talk about the bases and the colors. Okay. So anyway, So coming back to the peacock, I'm just taking how big peacock I want, and I will be starting with the neck here. So the shape here. So when we see a peacock, the neck is beautifully twisted. Like this. With a little bit of practice, you'll get the idea. There's no measurement of this. Sometimes with the movement, they will have the neck stretched up. And then that will happen like with the same thing. I'll just show you, though I don't intend to make it, it's just for your understanding. Here it is like this, and the beak will go a little curved downwards like this. Not much actually here, but if you want to make it a little shift, not in the same manner, you can actually go like this. So that is one stretched neck. If you want, it can hook it down. This is natural. So relaxed, more peeping out. So it totally depends on what movement you want to do it. I just gave you a little brief in here that about the movement of it. Do not make it like a stencil thing for all the peacocks that you make in the picture. Just a leaf shape. I have to see how much expansion I want to give to my peacock, and the other side I'm doing. Now this peacock is a full, the trail is all open and the peacock feather is open like that. Adjust to this. Now I'm not doing a very fine drawing of it, it's just. And how would you make a circle is just place your pencil right here. See, put a mark. Again, keep on turning, make a mark. And that's how you get a decent circle. Okay, this is for the very small ones who are working with me. My young children who are there. I know that there are very young ones. And now with a very soft hand, give it a line, so that you know that this is the curve, this is the expansion of the tail. Which green color is used in the leaves? Okay, Preeti, when I use the green, I will be posting a video also, you will get to know. This, what green I have, is a very bright green, and I have added many shades to get onto this. So this is a very sap green kind of a color, added by like brown, reds, yellow. So I'll post this video, and there I have talked about all the mixing and the proportions as well. So maybe by today, tonight or tomorrow, you'll get it. So now this is the expansion of the bird. Here, making the leg. Giving it a very rough look. Later when I'll be painting, I'll be doing it with the colors. So here, basically these two things, right? This. Making the eye, but the colors will define the eye, like it has more of a white. Now when we do this coloring here, I am just doing a little bit of circles. These are the guidelines of how the trail will go, how this whole tail is there. So I have made it like a rainbow. Now this is not, has, it doesn't have to be there. Here I'm placing my, the eyes on it. We call it eyes here. So I'm placing it in the equal distance. Now I have to alternate it like a tile. How do we put a tile? We are doing the same way. So one between the two. So this is the way we do it. So you don't have to be really calculative, but yes, a little you can reduce or you can give it expansion. That's only all your wish. So this is a basic thing already. So we don't do much of the drawing in this. Actually, I don't do that much also. I just wanted to show you. So these lines are not actually needed. So with the directly the colors, you can do it. So if you have done it really dark, you need to erase it if in case you would paint, because then it will be visible. We don't want your pencil lines to be visible. Always draw it with a lighter color pencil or a color pencil, water soluble color pencil, so that when you are drawing it, the color gets mixed with your poster colors, and you will not have that black or gray lines visible. So the best bet is take the water soluble watercolor pencils and draw. They are erasable also. So that's one trick. Shashikal, oh yes, in Mughal paintings, miniature painting also has a lot of details, and definitely it's known for its details. But Pichhwai has little less details, I would say. Not as the miniature paintings. Miniature paintings are like very, very small with high details. These are not very small. So miniature paintings are very small in size, whereas Pichhwai is ideally in feet. So it's much easier to get the detailing done in this art, rather than doing it in miniature. Miniature means very small bird will be made, and only that much is emphasized. All the shades, all the lines, all the fold streaks, everything will be line-based drawing. Miniature paintings are also line-based drawings. Here also it is this very much the same, but pitch-wise are not small. Now we have started making smaller paintings, but otherwise they were like around 7 feet. So miniature and pitch-wise is very different. Now here I will be taking the colors. Here I have a very basic blue. It's marina blue. Okay, so now how to adjust the tones of the paints, I will be telling you that as well. I'm using my existing palette, which I used for my Kamal Talai here. So I keep this handy. Now here I will be telling you different shades of the peacock. So when coming to the shades, black is the color that will, if you add it to any color, it will tone it to, it will be a darker tone. So white and black will fix the tone, and then mixing of the colors will give you different shades. So those are the things. So I'm taking blue. I'll just give you a moment. I'll open. Always take your paint out in a separate dish and mix as desired. So here I just took a little bit of it. Mix it well to give a... Here now, here in this, as like you asked miniature painting, here in this we are good with the brush and to do the brush. When we do miniature painting, we have to do a lot of gutai. Gutai in the sense, a lot of mixing in the color for a longer time so that all the fine details come. And in the miniature also, there is a burnishing paper. Burnishing of the paper means the paper is rough and then the burnishing is done with the agate stone. Here in agate stone is in Hindi, we call it hakik pathar. So it is a gemstone also. Some people wear it for benefits, but it is used in art also to give the glaze to the paper. So the paper is rubbed by hakik pathar or the agate stone, and then the glazing is done. Once the glazing of it is done, it's much easier to do the miniature work. In the normal paper, you will see that there is certain tooth in the paper, means there is a certain roughness. Not even if it's not glazed, it's not glassy, it has a matte texture, not very glossy. But when we do that rubbing, which we call burnishing, then that becomes very smooth. Only then the miniature will take place. Miniature cannot happen on this regular paper. Yeah, now I'll take. Now miniature is another study. Okay, and if in case miniature takes a lot of time, so that's the reason we cannot do miniature, full miniature in one workshops. But yes, we can always have a glance on it. So here it's the white. Now since I've taken it on the same brush, I have a certain amount of blue already, and it's giving me lighter shade. See to it that your color is smooth. Now a little darker. You have to give the grade of the color nicely. So on this side, if you get colors, you get the darker colors like a Persian blue. If in case you have a darker blue shade with you, you can use that. I'm taking a little bit black and the blue. To give the outer line. Now in this, in the poster colors also, you will see that you get very similar kind of colors in the cakes. Cakes are the colors like this, where you will have lots of shades. I'll open this and show you. Here, this is a very regular color palette, and you will have different shades of blue. So you have already five shades. What you have to do is just, you can use those also. By adding just a drop, I use a dropper for this so that I don't mix up all the colors and my colors stay intact. So just that much, and wait for a minute. Then from here also you can pick your colors with desirable whatever shade you want. You need a lot of shades, you can take that also. So take a darker one, ultramarine blue, Persian blue, ultramarine blue. You have to see that it's not too transparent. Here I'm adding a little bit of water and doing it. I'm just giving it a little wash. You can layer it and give it the shade. Now there is one more thing that I often do with my brushes. I do not wipe them with a cloth or a tissue. I squeeze all the water with my finger, so that, and this way I have that extra of it coming out, and then it's easier for you to blend. So I keep on using my hands for this also. Give a transition color so that your shading looks smoother, and follow the same direction where your flow is. I'll lower it down so that there is the water in the brush and the paint, so you will see that there is a lot of shining back because of the light. So somebody asked me whether I'm using glitter or not actually. So we do not do any glitter on this in the painting. Later I will be, when we will be doing the Shrinathji, I will be telling you about how to make the gold paint. So that is done. That's again a very extensive method of doing the paint. Generally with gold we see the ornaments, the palaces sometimes, or the jharukas. Not palaces are mainly seen in miniatures. In this we see there are jharukas and some parapets where these birds are. Just balancing it a little and following the same kind of shade work. So wherever it is the depth, you will see that the color goes a little darker. Take very little at a time. I did this part. I'll wait till this dry. Ma'am, it's zoomed a lot. I actually did. Just for whatever lines are hard, rub with a wet brush and you will have that smooth. The smoothness. So, but yes, if your strokes are moving in the same direction, it's not a glass finish for the bird. You don't want it. It should be looking very natural. Now here, going on to this part, I will be taking few colors. I'm taking yellow. Red. use a separate palette for everything, and later you can also just spray a little bit of water on your existing ones and your palette is all ready. So here I mixed a little bit of blue what was there with me and red to get this grayish shade. Now this is actually shining too much. The shade is gray. Okay. And now just wash your brush. I'm just preparing my shades right now. So yellow and red. A little scarlet orangish shade. I'll be mixing a little white also. To give it a peachy look. Now I'm not adding everything at one go because then I want that grades of color. So this side it's a little peachy, this side it's a little red. Here it's more concentrated. So just give it an even wash. Always be very careful on your stroke work. No matter it has to be filled, but you have to follow the stroke where it has to go. Do not go up and down. So move in the direction of the wing. So just one simple wash. By this time this has dried up. So here is the red. I need to take a little bit more red. Now with a very fine brush, I'm giving the strokes. You have to follow the same and go on this side. Whenever we do not take a very high grade color to do it in one go. We gradually bring up the shades. So this gives a nice warmth to the picture. It's not very contrasting. It's not the high contrast is there. Of course, there's a very bright contrast. So here we see that it's contrasting, but the transition from the light blue to the dark blue is very subtle. So there are not very harsh lines here also. We will be doing it with black as well. But then first, you may want to draw this with pencil or color pencil if in case you feel that your strokes will go blurry or whatever. Over this, you can always use your color pencils to draw. Do not use your black pens or your pencil because that will show up and then we can actually do without it also. So use color pencils. Now here I'm taking my yellow and a little bit of white to give it a lighter. Whenever you add white to any of the color, the opacity of the color changes. So the color is not transparent, it becomes opaque. So that is very important. Knowing the nature of the colors, when to just add water. If you add water to a color, it will be transparent. You can still see the beneath thing. If you add a little bit of white, it will become chalky and opaque. So I'm giving those subtle fur like things, and I'm not drawing the full thing. That is when these practicing of the strokes come really handy. I've done it in the first day where it was just a kind of a warm-up session of about these strokes. See to it that they have a force in them, and when it moves to the end, it should be hair thin, so it should not be very flat and like we are doing it with a white pen or something. So do not try doing it with pens like a jelly roll or something. Try with the brush. With this small shift or a jerk, you will get the flow of your strokes. Now here I'm adding between these reds so that I get more natural looking fur like this. While doing this, you have to work on your force, but you will not press your brush. Once you press your brush, your bristles go flat and you get tight lines. You don't want those lines to be very solid. Sometimes you will see that left side comes very easily and the right side is not coming so easily. That happens. So sometimes our muscles are not in tune of working in the opposite direction. So that's why few strokes need a little bit more practice, but do not get disheartened. Please keep practicing. See to it that your brush is not very dry also, not very wet. So your strokes should come very fine. The consistency of paint and water should be very nicely checked. How do you check it? It's like this, what I am taking is a little thicker than milk consistency. So, with very less water. Water is only used in this, not to give transparency here, but just to make your color flow. Your brush glides nicely. Here, this is done. Now I'm adding the bases of this whole tail. Now for this you can add a very dark blue or a very dark green, that is both okay. Sometimes we've also seen that blue adds with a little black and gives a very darker tone in this. So totally depends on what you are working on the background. So your picture should come very, I'll just hold it a little up and clear the place so that you get the idea of how big actually the picture is. So here, okay, now here I have zoomed in a different manner here. This is the beginning here. I've kept the margin. Once again, I'm just showing you the thing. The bird is around, if in case I measure it, but I don't measure it when I draw. It's about 4.5 inches from toe to the height. And how is the width of it? It is around 5 inches. Around 5 inches. It's wet. I didn't keep it down. So this is there. Here it is, the Kamal Talai that we did in the previous class. Now this was shown again. I'm repeating. This was shown, but you'll get the hints of all the things that we have done in a following video. So we'll go on to this one again. I guess it's dried. Yeah. Now I am doing a very darker blue here, darker green, sorry. And for that I'll just show you where This is the color. Now, this is a very local palette, if I may say. It's a very local palette, as in all the colors are, all the shades are not marked with colors. So it's, I think, DOMS or any other thing. Yeah, I think it's DOMS. So it's not important that what brand or what thing of color you have. It's about you want to do it, you have color, start painting. Okay. So in olden days, these pigments were obtained from minerals, and gum was mixed to get it permanent. Now here, when we will be making the, it's out of focus, I guess. Yeah. When we will be making the gold, when we'll make the gold, then also you will see that the gold pigments are added to the glue, and that's how we add it, we make it. So here I'm taking this turquoise kind of a color, which is in the palette, and it is a basic straight wash, so I'm not doing any detailing. Here you can use a flat brush also to fill up, because the area is very big. So just giving it a wash, because we will be layering it with colors. Now I am doing it full in green right now, whereas we have to leave, sometimes we would see that we leave the eyes. These are called the eyes on it. But here, if you would want to just add the color and later you want to add it, then also it works fine. So just going flat on the color. See, my thing got frayed a little. Even if you draw those eyes, after coloring also, you will be able to see your details. So that is the reason we prefer that, okay, few of the details are drawn. We'll have to wait till the time it dries, because we will have to build up the details on it. And before drying, if we do it, then it gets mixed up. So we'll just make a few areas where I see that the color should be a little darker over the edges. I'm just doing it a little dark towards the end, so that when I do my backgrounds, I will get a good contrast. Just fill it flat. There's no shade work right now involved. Once it dries, we will all cover up these lines, because there is a very high level of line work that will go on the tail. So do not worry if your lines are actually seen. I'm not blending these lines, but trying to maintain the inside out strokes. So my all the lines are moving from inside to outside, not crossing the tail. Now, I'll wait for it to dry because it's very important for that. We will catch up onto that. Till then, I will be showing you. Now, those things I did, but I didn't do anything with white and the water lilies, which are white in color. So by the time our peacock is getting ready, for details, we will go on to this one. I'll show you how to work on that. So I'm just using my marina blue and white. Okay. It's not important that you have this shade of blue or that shade. Any lighter sky blue kind of a shade will work. I'll bring it down. And here I'll be showing you the colors. Again, on the palette, always take out your fresh colors in a fresh place. It should not touch with anything that is already with any color like blacks and reds that are mixing into it. So here I'm taking it in the white, and the same way as I did my lotus, which is pink, I'm doing the base color here. Now I will be doing it a little quick. So just giving the base of all the petals. With a very lighter tone, you will see that it's not white at all. It's not pure white. There's a small tint of blue. Can you tell how to mix the turquoise color? Just mix a blue and green together. Emerald. So just fill these, and now I'm taking my blue. So the same blue that I have. Again, squeeze out the color. If in case you are, if you feel that the color is too much, you can always take a tissue paper for your help, but do not do it on the cloth, I would say. So here, so just make a point nicely and then go on to this one. Your strokes should be very soft and very thin here. Now it is showing, I don't know, yeah, now you can see that, because sometimes when my hand comes in the middle, the focus changes to my hand. Now here again, the same way as we did the other one. The technique goes the same, only the color changes. But yes, these also look very beautiful, the white lilies. It's not the pond that is full of with lotuses. We have white lilies also, you can do that. And it does give a very beautiful variation. I'm picking it from my hand itself, not going onto the palette, because sometimes it gets a little too much to pick. Now the basic shade is done, but still this gets really if you leave it right now, then it gets really bad actually, because then your pencil lines are visible. You need to cover up all your pencil lines with blue. Take a little darker shade. And just make a line. Your lines will not be like the pen, so they have to start with a little thicker and end with a thin stroke. Now these are not like you have to do it like this. Sometimes we just do it with one straight line. Can we do this with pale yellow for water lilies? Pale yellow, maybe, yeah, why not try? But then again, the base of the color will be white. So you can just tint it with, we do coral reds, we do crimson, we do primary red, different shades of blue. For it is like you will have a very good hold on your brush if you hold your breath. That is one trick. So initially I used to do that. Now I'm okay talking and doing it, but yes, while practicing you have to let go. So your breathing gets very slow while you're doing it. Such work. So this finishes here. And for the green, just take the blue and the red and the green here, and you can overlap with the place. So here, just go over your waters and make the step. So this much opacity will be covered, and you don't have to really wait that, okay, I have to leave that place for my stem, because then your flow of the base lines will get disturbed. So it's always wisable to do the stem over. Just a small shade work on this, a little white on the top. Though these are very thin lines, still it looks beautiful if all the details are covered. So, a little dark, that's black on the other side to give it the depth. So it stands out from the waters. So this is how we have done this water lily. I've shown you. You can actually go ahead and do the same. Different shades of pinks and blues can be tried. Now the reason why why I tried this as a water lily is because I don't want blue and grays to be together, because they would not give a very good contrast. The contrast won't be very high. So that's why all those which are standing against the ground, or the green grass or the brown here on the land, will stand with this water lily here. Okay, so this is how it comes. I'll just try to lift it up to show you better. So here, this is the, so much clearer now. This is the water lily. So avoid bringing the water lilies close to the water until and unless you are doing the dark, the black waters, whenever the night sky you are doing, then only you can do this. Because it is only the appeal of the painting that will get hampered. It's not that it is not there, or sometimes it's not seen, but if you work on it, you really want it to be shown, right? So now we'll work on this bird. Now taking my colors really dark. Now here, this is one place where you may want to do your pen this, but I'll just show you for those who want to. So here it is a 10 and here it is a 7. So take a thinner point. So whenever you have your poster colors, you will see that the water comes up and the color settles down. Always before using it, give it a nice stir so that you get the nice and thick color. So I'll just give it. I'll make those eyes what are there. you would want it to dry between the strokes, between the colors when you will be doing. Don't take too much of water. You can also use your acrylics now over it. I'm just giving those dots. It will take some time for it to dry because these are thicker dots because I'm doing it over green. Place it between the two, like a mandala. These are very thick dots and it will take some time to dry. So here in the life, actually what happens sometimes when we need that time of drying, we don't get that much time. So here we'll see if in case it dries, we can create the detail work as well. Can we do this with the pale yellow? Okay, yeah, I've already answered that. Any other questions, please write it down, because by the time I'll wait for it to dry a little, I can answer all your queries. And if you're liking the video, please press the like button. Also, share it with others and do subscribe the channel also. Yes, because Artful Studio is always bringing such videos all for free. No workshop, paid workshops are promoted here right now, and so all the workshops will be all free and you can learn your art forms. You can also place your requests on certain art forms and it will be considered, and we'll always take it, note it, and we will do it. Neha ma'am, what is this sheet? This sheet is a normal sketch pad and it's a A3 size. Which paint is this, Vaishnavi? It's poster. I told you it's the poster color. This is the box that I was using. Just a basic 6 shade of the colors are out. This is the dabba. Okay. And now here. Now, as I told you that when we want opacity in the picture, we mix it with white. So here I want a little opaque water. Opaque means not the color should not shine through it. And here I will be mixing yellow with white. When I mix yellow with white, it becomes very chalky and it will show up very thin lines also. Take a thinner brush, pointed brush for this. I'll change my brush and I'm taking 2 in camel rounded synthetic brush. Now, there is one fashion that we'll follow, is like the making the fans here. I'll just zoom in a little. Like this. This will take some time. This is not a very quick work. This is the line work that we do. So kind of make the bowls where you've made this. From here to here. Now for this, it is very important that they are tiled nicely, as I told you. Like this. And here we will be just doing these lines. See to it that it's with the force. So it's starting from the corner up, and then it's not even touching the dot. So don't touch the dot. Do not press your brush. Your thin lines will be very thin. We'll take a little bit more time to finish this picture. We'll actually finish the bird today. Now the picture won't be completed. We'll continue on the next class, that is tomorrow, and we'll do a little bit of more ways how we can give the peahens also around it, and how to make different elements, different tree structures and all tomorrow. This is the line work that we do with the stroke, okay, with not with just like proper lines. The stroke has to is very important. And see at the bottom, wherever the lines were, they are all hidden now, so you don't get to see those lines. We'll continue with the same formation till we end the whole day. Now once you practice these strokes, it will come very handy when you'll do the trees. So this is it. Here we will be doing a little bit on the beak. I'm taking the same coral pink that I used for the feather. This is the kalingi or the crown, what we call. Okay. Taking a little black for the eye area. While the black dries, then we will be doing some highlight on the eye, because when we see the peacock, we see a lot of white in the eye also. So we will do that. Meanwhile, I'm doing some black outlining for the bird. Giving it the little refined look with the black outline. So wherever it feels that okay, it's getting settled with the background or the close by things, this will just pop out. Very fine, very very fine strokes are very important, otherwise it'll not create the layer. Now here what I did in the previous was stroke not go out the semicircle. Should the stroke not go out in the semi of out of the semicircle? No, it will be all the background there. See to it that you are doing on the red, and you will see that there is a layering really helps in it. So it is not that okay, if you would have done it directly with black, the shade work would have been different. Now taking the white. It's still my black is still wet, so it's getting a little grayish tone here. Just give a nice cover to the eye, which is in white. We'll move down to the feet. Though when we are doing the backgrounds, it's better that we do the backgrounds first and then do the feet. But still, as it is, we are just covering only the bird. I'll just show you how to go about it. Now again, using the same peachy color, or you can just give it a little dull tone by making it a little grayish brown. Yeah. So. Not very detailed, it's anyway we are not doing the miniature work, so just this way you can just do it over the whatever the background is, giving it a little more highlight. Just add a little white to the back and maybe a darker tone to the front. Yeah, that's it, and they will stand out to whatever base is there. So there's one more. My yellow is dried and I will be doing a little bit more color here. The concentric circles will always be there for the eye, for the eye of the bird. And I'm taking the blue. Just add blue, orange, red, or orange also. So here if you layer it, this yellow is very wet. Yes, it is. My yellow is not dried, so it's kind of pulling the color. But once your blue dries, you can just give it a dot of orange, and then it'll really brighten up the whole picture. once this orange is added, it will just look very beautiful. So this is how we do the Pichhwai peacock. Can we draw only peacock? Yes, of course you can draw peacock itself. Like as I told you, you can take many different elements and do it differently. What I am doing is since I have to show you, I'm just building it into a one whole some picture. But then it's not that we will be doing one picture in one go. So it will take a lot of time working on it. So here the lily I showed you today. What we covered today is the lily, and this all portion was actually covered, and you can have a look. I will try to post it today or maybe tomorrow morning before tomorrow's session you'll get it. And this is how we make the peacock. I hope you all liked it. If you have any questions regarding it, please write it down, and we will try to do different other forms also of the peacocks. Maybe we will do how to draw different sort of peacock motions, like sitting, dancing. Of course it is dancing, sitting on the tree, or there are many ways we can put the same element in a different form to create the wholesome effect for the picture. So this is what it is, and tomorrow we will try to finish this picture doing all the groundwork, basically how to make the ground and the clouds. We'll do that. We will try to figure out a few stroke work in the bushes, and next week we have another thing coming up. Really be excited with that, because that is the most awaited video and in Pichhwai, and many people know it, that Pichhwai is only that form. So but Pichhwai is not only that form. That form is Shrinathji, and it is a form of Pichhwai. So Pichhwai, it's not, Pichhwai is a very vast subject, vast topic, where different elements are there, Shrinathji is one type of it. So we will be doing that as well. I hope you liked it. Press the like button, so that, do write your comments on it so that I get to hear from you. And yes, of course, any questions, I'll be more than happy to help you out. Once again, a very, very happy new year to each one of you. Enjoy the evening. And yes, I pray for each one of us for this year to be very good for all of us. So thank you all. I'll see you tomorrow.